When a severe occlusive disease is present at the origin of the left renal artery, an endoarterectomy is performed before reattaching the artery. The use of intraoperative stenting reveals very useful to fix the intimal flap in case of unsuccessful endarterectomy. Here an example of a left renal artery treated either with an endarterectomy followed by direct stenting with good result. Usually, the left renal artery is reattached separately by an 8mm Dacron graft interposition. The reimplantation of a large amount of native aorta and the inclusion technique for TAA repair carries the risk for subsequent recurrent aneurysm formation. We developed an original computerized technique based on preoperative measure of the relative distance among the visceral vessels on CT scan to obtain a virtual reproduction of the opened aneurysm before surgery. The computed aortic model is then printed to preview the effective relative position of the visceral ossea. The surgeon can add this information in the selection criteria of the graft. When a large amount of native aorta should be included in our repair, a multi-branch graft is usually preferred. This prosthesis allows single vessel reattachment, effectively reducing the risk of recurrent aortic patch aneurysm. These individual anastomoses can be safely and quickly accomplished when the visceral vessels are far away from each other, but can be technically difficult if the vessels originate close together. Finally, an end-to-end anastomosis with the distal aorta is performed, and the last clamp removed. In some cases, like extended type 1 thoracoabdominal, the visceral arteries can be incorporated in a beveled distal anastomosis. Open surgical repair of thoracoabdominal aortic aneurysms has evolved significantly over the last decades, thanks to technical improvements, especially in the area of organ protection. However, despite adjunctive strategies, morbidity and mortality rates are still not negligible. Patient selection has to be based on a careful preoperative assessment and risk evaluation. Surgical TAA repair is to be performed in high-volume centers by experienced surgeons. Conventional treatment is the gold standard for patients fit for open surgery. The hybrid or endovascular treatment is currently indicated only in a subset of patients, and morbidity and mortality are still significant. Further studies are needed to assess the safety, efficacy, and long-term benefits of these techniques.